Hello everyone, welcome to Sekhon Education. I am Sukhvinder, here with our next lecture. In this lecture, we study about the Mollier chart. This is the fourth lecture relating to the steam properties. In the previous three lectures, we already studied about the different topics. In first topic, we studied what is steam and how we can generate a steam, that is the formation curve of steam. In the second lecture, we studied about the various terms relating to the steam, such as superheated, cooling, subcooling, and the latent heat, sensible heat, dryness fraction. And in third lecture, that is all about the steam table numericals based upon the Rankine cycle. So all these three lectures are available in English version as well as in Hindi version. Okay, this is our fourth lecture. In this lecture, we studied about the Mollier charts. So first of all, what is Mollier chart? As we know, there are different charts relating to the steam, TS chart, HS chart, PV chart, the different charts that are available. However, when we get a graphical representation for the different parameters relating to steam, such as a pressure, temperature, specific volume, specific enthalpy, and specific entropy on a specific chart, that is the HS chart, that is the specific enthalpy and specific entropy chart, then that graphical representation is known as the Mollier chart. In this chart, on the x-axis, there is a specific entropy in the units of kilojoule per kg Kelvin, and on the y-axis, there is a specific enthalpy in the terms of kilojoule per kg. Here I mentioned the various lines. These lines, as per the diagram that I used in this video. So the dotted green line, pink line, black line, red lines. So I suggest to everyone to use the Mollier chart for solving the numericals. Those are the color ones, because it is very easy to locate any point in a colorful chart as compared to the total black and white chart. So there is a chances of error for while solving the numericals on a totally black chart. Okay, now this is the diagram of the Mollier chart. I know it is not properly visible because it is the chart that around of 4 to 5 sheets of A4 sheets. So I just take a snap and add over here. I also give the Google Drive link in which there is a steam table and the Mollier chart is added. So you can download it and you can zoom it on your mobile or on your personal PC. So there are certain colorful lines on this chart. Okay, there is a green line over here. So I just mentioned that the dotted green line, that I mentioned that it is the specific volume line, constant volume line. Okay, these are the lines, this green dotted lines. I will show you a little bit in the zoom version. Okay, these dotted lines, these are the constant volume lines, specific volume lines. Okay, these lines are in the having units meter cube per kg. Okay, then there is a dark line at the center of the chart, that is a saturation line. This dark line, this is the saturation line. As we already discussed in our previous lectures about the formation curve of steam and how we can use the steam table. In those, I just mentioned that there is a saturation curve in the formation of steam from ice to superheated steam. Okay, and this graphical representation is just the right side portion of that diagram. Okay, this is the curve part. As we know, this curve part, inside this curve, there is a region where we having two phases. Phases means it is both in liquid as well as in vapor phase. So this is a saturation line. On this line, we having a temperature. For example, for normal atmospheric pressure conditions, atmospheric pressure, and this is the, for water, this is the 100 degrees Celsius line, saturation line. Okay, on this line, at one side, we having a saturation vapor line. On the other side, which continue towards this, that is the saturation liquid line. Okay, so inside this, we having a mixture. So it is also showing that there is a constant dryness fraction line. As I already discussed in our previous lecture, what is dryness fraction? It is the quantity or amount of moisture that penetrates in the steam. That is the dryness fraction. So these lines, these dark lines, these dark pink lines, these are the constant dryness fraction lines. The value of dryness fraction is varies from 0 to 1. The maximum value is 1. So here its value is from 0.7, 0.75, 0.8. So in between here is 0.81, 82, 83, 84, then 85. So these are the dryness fraction line. This means it tells about the moisture content that present in the steam. Inside this green dark line, the steam having the moisture. So it is the wet steam. Okay, so we can say it tells about the quantity of wet steam, how much amount of moisture is present. However, above this pink line, we having totally dry steam, that is the superheated steam. Okay, so another lines, these black lines which are going towards the upper part, these black lines where it is mentioned, that is the constant pressure lines. These are the constant pressure lines. So these pressure lines are varying and moving along this side. Okay, here is the lowest pressure, okay, that is 0.01 bar, and it is moving towards this side. Okay, then these lines are known as the constant temperature lines. This, okay, these are the value of these lines is more than 100 degrees Celsius. So this is 100 degrees Celsius, 150, 200, even we have 50 degrees Celsius, but this is outside the saturation line, therefore it is also for the superheated region, in the superheated region. Okay, on this chart at one side, this side, that is 1700, 1800, this is the specific enthalpy, that is small h. Even it is not mentioned over here, it is the specific, but small h means it is the specific enthalpy. Okay, because it is divided with kilojoule. Because we know the units of enthalpy, it is the energy, it is a kilojoule. Okay, when we divided any energy with the respect to mass, it becomes the specific term, that is the kg. Okay, similarly, there is the, at the x-axis, there is an entropy that is noted with small s. So it is also a specific entropy, as the unit is representing kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Okay, so okay, this is upper part. Okay, as it is showing over here, the maximum value of pressure that can we check is 1000 bar. So this line 1000 bar, 800 bar, 600 bar, 500. So these are the, all are the pressure lines. Okay, similarly, these reds, these are curving lines. These are known as the constant temperature lines. These are in the terms of degree Celsius. So maximum temperature that can we check on the Mollier chart, that is 800 degrees Celsius. So this is just a graphical version that of the whole Mollier chart that we check on the in the previous lectures. In the previous lectures, we having different steam tables for saturation steam, for superheated steam, and even we having a different tables for saturated enthalpy, saturated entropy, and saturated specific volume in some type of steam tables. However, in the Mollier chart, we get all the informations that is present in the steam table on one single chart. So even though it is little bit complicated, but it is very convenient to solve the numericals in a very easy way. So in the coming lecture, I will discuss how we can locate any point in the Mollier chart and how we can solve the numericals with the help of Mollier chart. That's all for today. I hope you understand today's lecture. Please subscribe my YouTube channel and also press on the bell icon so that you can get the notification about the coming videos. Thank you. Stay tuned.